A very good morning to my dear students. Hope you all are good, fit and fine. I'm your social studies teacher. So today we are going to start chapter number 9. Major landforms and water bodies. So as in our last video, we have discussed exercises of chapter number 8. So today we are going to discuss chapter number 9, major landforms and water bodies. So I request you all to open your social studies book, page number 71, chapter number 9, theme 4. So class, let's start. So firstly, before studying major landforms and water bodies, we should know that what do you know and what are landforms? Do you know what are landforms? Yes, landforms are the natural features and shapes existing on the surface of the earth. Once again, they are the natural features and shape existing on the surface of the earth. They have different physical characteristics and are spread out all over the planet of the earth. Different shapes of land that is spread all over the earth is your landforms. You must have noticed that the earth is not the same everywhere. When you go in the hilly areas, there are mountains. When you go in the desert areas, there are desert. When you go in the plain, there are plains. So earth is not same everywhere. The land part of the earth is high at some places and too low at other. Some areas are lush green while others are dry and barren. Oceans and continents constitute to form very large landforms, whereas the mountains, vast plains and plateaus come under the category of large landform. Individual mountains, hills, valleys, rivers, banks and hillside slopes form to be the intermediate and small landforms. So the oceans and continents, they are the large landform, where the mountains, vast plains and plateaus, they come under the category of landform, large landform. But individual mountains, hills, valleys, river banks, hillsides, so they are under the category of small landforms. So come, let's learn about the major landforms in detail. So in detail, we are going to discuss about one by one all the different types of the landforms. So firstly, we'll start. Different landforms are given in our book, so let's start that. Mountains. Firstly, we are going to discuss about the mountains. So let's start. Mountains are the natural elevation on the earth's surface. They are the highest landforms, usually found with broad base and conical top with steep sides. They occupy almost 1/4 of the total land area of the earth. Now, what are mountains? Mountains are the natural elevation, means they are elevated area, elevation, natural elevation on the earth's surface. And they are the highest landforms, usually found with broad base. They are having the broad base with conical top with steep sides. Okay. And they all occupy almost 1/4 of the total land of the area of the earth. Means full of the land area of the earth, 1/4 is covered by the mountains. The pointed tip of the mountain is called the peak. Now, the conical top, the pointed tip of the mountain is called the peak. A series of mountains is called a mountain range. when a series of mountain is there, continuously mountains are there, that is called the range. The Himalayas are the longest mountain range, and in India, Himalayas are the longest mountain range. The temperature on the mountains remains less now. There the temperature also remains less as compared to the plains. As we see, the Mount Everest, it is the highest mountain peak in the world. Once again, Mount Everest is the highest mountain peak in the world. So this we have discussed about the mountains. Once again, I will repeat. They are the natural elevation on the Earth's surface and are like by 1/4 part of the land on the Earth is covered with mountains. And the pointed tip of the mountain is called the peak. And the series of mountain is called the mountain range. Himalayas are the longest mountain range. And there usually temperature is very less as compared to the plains. And Mount Everest is the highest mountain peak in the world. So now, second one we have plateau. As you can see in the picture, these are the types of the plateaus. So now, we are going to discuss about the plateaus. So let's start. Plateaus are elevated highland with more or less flat surface on its top. It has a large area on its top and a steep or gentle slope on its sides. They are surrounded by lower land or mountain ranges. Now, what is plateau? Actually, they are not as much as elevated like mountains, but they are somewhat elevated highland. Not so much, only somewhat, with more or less flat surface on its top. It has large area on its top. On its top, it has a large area and a steep gentle slope on its side. Now they are surrounded by the lower land or the mountain ridges. They can be surrounded by the lower land. Okay. So due to the flat top, these landforms are also known as tablelands or highlands. Now some elevation is there, and after elevation on its top, flat land is there. So that's why due to the flat top, these landforms are also known as the tablelands or highlands. The height of the plateau varies from a few hundred meters to 1,000 meters. Now the different they have the different heights, and their height varies from 100 meters to 1,000 meters. So some of the plateaus names are also given, so we'll discuss that. The Deccan Plateau in India, the Western Plateau in Australia, the Mongolian Plateau, etc. are some important plateau of the world. In India, it is the Deccan Plateau. In Australia, Western Plateau, Mongolian Plateau, etc. These are some of the important plateau in the world. So now we'll move to the next. We have plains. You must be very much familiar with the plains, because we are living in the plains. So let's start our plains. Plains are the vast stretches of flat land. They have little change in elevation, are usually lower than the land surrounding them. Plains near the oceans are called coastal plains. Most of the big cities are located in the plains, as it is easier to build houses, buildings, roads and other structures in plains. Hence, they are heavily polluted, populated and polluted as well. Now, what is plain? They are the vast stretches of the flat land. Flat land is known as the plains. They have little change in the elevation and are usually lower than the land surrounding them. Plains, the plains which are near the sea, oceans, they are known as the coastal plains. Now most of the big cities, like you can see that Delhi is there. Many of the cities which are big cities, they are located in the plains. Because why it is? Because it is very easy to build houses, buildings, roads and other structures in the plains. Hence they are heavily populated and polluted as well. As that's why plains are very populated, because the life on the plains is very easy. So that's why they are heavily populated and polluted as well. So some of the plains are given here: the Northern Plains of India, Nile Valley Plains of Africa, Yangtze Plains of China, etc. are some significant plains of the world. So these three main plains are given here. Northern Plains in India, Nile Valley Plains in Africa, Yangtze Plains of China. So now let's move on to our next one. We have deserts. So now we are going to discuss about the desert. You might have heard about that. You might have read also. So we are going to discuss about that today. Deserts are large area and barren area of lands which receive little or no rainfall throughout the year. Now what is land? What is desert? Deserts are large area. They are very dry, barren area of land where there is no rainfall or very little rainfall throughout the year. Now here the weather condition is extreme, very hot in a day and very cold at night. There are two types of desert found, hot desert and cold desert. Hot deserts are covered with sand. Animals like camels, snakes, lizards and rats can be found there. Thar desert in India is a hot desert. Cold deserts are covered with snow. They receive snowfall during winter. Animals like penguins, whales and fur seals can be found in these deserts. Antarctica is the world's biggest cold desert. Now, when we read about desert, dry barren lands come to our mind. But there are two types of desert. One is hot desert and cold desert. Hot desert are covered with the snow. Animals like snake, camels, lizard, these are found. And in India, Thar desert is the hot desert. But cold desert, they are covered with the snow. They are not covered with the sand. They are covered with snow. They receive snowfall during winter. Now there, penguins, whales and fur seals are found in these type of desert. And Antarctica is the world's biggest cold desert. So now we are going to discuss our next landform, that is our islands. As by seeing the picture, you might have understood what is the island. So let's start, everyone. Island is a piece of subcontinental land that is surrounded by water. The Andaman and Nicobar and Lakshadweep are the Indian islands situated in the Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea respectively. Now what is the land? What is an island? Island, it is a piece of a subcontinent land where everywhere it is surrounded by water. As you have seen in the picture, between there is a land and it's surrounded by the water. Now Andaman and Nicobar, Lakshadweep, they are the Indian island that are situated in the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea. Okay. So today we have discussed our five types of landform: mountains, plateaus, plain, deserts, island. So I request you all to read the types of landform once again so that you can understand more properly, like what is desert, what is plain, what is island, what is mountains, what is plateaus. So read once again. So class, thank you for listening to me. Stay safe, stay at home and keep studying. God bless you, everyone.